In part two of our lesson on the double angle identities, you will learn about applications of the double angle identities for cosine, sine, and tangent. In this first example, we are given that cosine of 2 theta is equal to 4/5, that theta lives in quadrant 2, and we have to find the sine of theta. So we're given a double angle for cosine, and remember that there were three forms of the double angle identity. We have to choose which one we want to use, and in this case, because we are being asked to find sine of theta, it makes sense to use the identity that involves sine. So we will use the identity that says cosine of 2 theta is equal to 1 minus 2 sine squared of theta. Now on the left-hand side, we can substitute in the value for cosine of 2 theta that we were given, 4/5. On the right-hand side, we have 1 minus 2 sine squared theta. Now in this equation, we're going to be able to solve for sine of theta. I always like to have my variables be positive, so I'm going to take the 2 sine of theta, because it's a minus on the right-hand side, I'm going to bring it over to the left-hand side so that it becomes positive 2 sine squared theta. On the right-hand side, we had the 1, it's staying there. We're taking the 4/5 that was on the left-hand side, and we'll bring it over to the right-hand side, so it becomes minus 4/5. On the right-hand side, we can do this subtraction. It becomes 1/5. The left-hand side is 2 sine squared theta. We're trying to get the sine of theta by itself, so we will take each side and multiply by 1/2. So now we have sine squared of theta is equal to 1/10. By the square roots property, we know then that sine of theta will be plus or minus the square root of 1/10, which of course is plus or minus, well, the square root of 1 in the numerator is 1. We have radical 10 in the denominator. We will want to rationalize by multiplying by radical 10 over radical 10. So this is plus or minus radical 10 over 10. Now we have to decide whether this will be positive radical 10 over 10 or negative radical 10 over 10. And what decides that is the quadrant that theta lives in. So we know that theta is in quadrant 2. Because theta is in quadrant 2, we know that sine of theta has to be positive. So finally then, we have that sine of theta is going to be positive radical 10 over 10. In this example, we are given that the sine of theta is 1/3 and that theta lives in quadrant 2. So first order of business is to draw a picture of theta. We know theta is here in quadrant 2. And we were given that its sine is 1/3. So we know the y value is 1, r is equal to 3, and because we are in quadrant 2, x will have to be negative. To solve for x, we know it's going to be the negative of the square root of r squared, so 3 squared, minus y squared, 1 squared, which is negative radical 9 minus 1, which is negative radical 8. We know that radical 8 can be written as radical 4 times radical 2, so this simplifies to be negative 2 radical 2. You always want to make sure you simplify your radicals. 8 has a perfect square of 4 in it. Radical 4 reduces to 2. And then the radical 2 stays radical 2. So we come to our picture and we can label our x value negative 2 radical 2. Now we have to find three things: sine 2 theta, tangent 2 theta, and quadrant of 2 theta. Let's start by writing the identity for sine of 2 theta, which equals 2 times sine theta cosine theta. And now we will substitute in the values. We have 2 times the sine of theta. We go right to the picture. We know sine will be the y value divided by r, so 1 over 3. Next, we have to get cosine of theta, which we know is x over r, so that will be negative 2 radical 2 over 3. We're going to get a rational expression whose denominator will be 3 times 3, which is 9, whose numerator will be 2 times 1 times negative 2 rad 2, which is negative 4 radical 2. So there's sine of 2 theta. Next, we can find tangent of 2 theta. We start by writing the identity that it's equal to 2 times the tangent of theta over 1 minus tangent squared theta. And let's start substituting in the values. In the numerator, we're going to have 2, and the tangent of theta we know is going to be the y value divided by x. Now we can see we're going to have a radical in the denominator. So I would suggest that you come off here to the side and say that tangent theta is going to be 1 over negative 2 radical 2. And let's go ahead and rationalize this. We've got times radical 2 over radical 2. We are going to get that the tangent of theta is equal to negative radical 2 divided by, well, this radical 2 times this radical 2 is 2, and then we multiply that times 2, and we get 4. So when we substitute for tangent of theta in the identity, let's use this cleaned up version of negative radical 2 over 4. In the denominator of the identity, we have 1 minus the tangent squared. So we've already figured out what the tangent is. It's negative radical 2 over 4, and here we're going to need to square it. Now, in the numerator, this 2 is going to cancel with the 4, and we're going to end up with negative radical 2 over 2. In the denominator, we have 1 minus. Now, when we square radical 2, we're going to get 2. When we square 4, we're going to get 16. And we know that that will reduce to 1 over 8. So this is now negative radical 2 over 2 over 1 minus 1 eighth. So we have 8 over 8 minus 1 over 8 is going to be 7 over 8. Simplifying this, we have negative radical 2 over 2, and dividing by 7 eighths is the same as multiplying by 8 over 7. We see we can cancel here. 2 goes into 2 once, 2 goes into 8 4 times, and we have negative 4 radical 2 in the numerator, and in the denominator we have 7. So this is the tangent of 2 theta. Now lastly, we are being asked to find the quadrant of 2 theta. Now we discovered that the sine of 2 theta was negative. And that the tangent of 2 theta was also negative. These two combined, when the sine is negative and the tangent is negative, we know that 2 theta is in quadrant 4. In this example, we're given that the cosine of theta is 1/4, and that theta lives between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi. We have to find the cosine of 2 theta, the tangent of 2 theta, and the quadrant of 2 theta. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Let's see how you did. So this tells us that theta is going to be in quadrant 4. Now we're given that the cosine is 1/4, so we know the x value will be 1, r will be 4, and because we're in quadrant 4, the y value is going to be negative. 1/4 is going to be negative square root of r squared, so 4 squared, minus x squared, 1 squared. So we get negative radical 16 minus 1, which is negative radical 15. So we can come over to the picture and put negative rad 15 in for the y value. The first thing we have to find is cosine of 2 theta, so we start with the identity. And for cosine of 2 theta, we have three choices, and we can use any of the three. We're going to get exactly the same answer no matter which one we use. In this case, I would probably be tempted to use 2 cosine squared theta minus 1, since we were given the value of cosine theta in the problem, and I know that's going to be an exact value. So now we substitute in 2 times 1/4 squared minus 1. We know that's going to be 2 times 1/16 minus 1. And we know the 2 and the 16 will reduce, so 2 goes into 2 once and into 16 8 times. So we have 1/8 minus 1, which you can write as 8/8. And so this is negative 7/8. We know that the cosine of 2 theta is negative 7/8. Now the tangent of 2 theta, we start by writing down the identity. 2 times the tangent of theta divided by 1 minus the tangent squared of theta. We want to fill in the values. The numerator is 2 times tangent of theta will come from the picture, and we know that it is the y value divided by x, so negative root 15 over 1 is negative root 15. In the denominator, we have to do 1 minus the tangent squared of theta, so negative radical 15 squared. This will become negative 2 radical 15 divided by 1 minus. Now negative radical 15 squared becomes positive 15. And remember that we're subtracting that. So you have to think of doing the negative radical 15 squared first, which is positive 15, and then you do 1 minus 15. So we have negative 2 radical 15 divided by negative 14. And we see that this will become positive radical 15 over 7, because 2 cancels into the 14, making it a 7. Lastly, we had to find the quadrant of 2 theta. And looking at our results, we see that the cosine of 2 theta is negative. The tangent of 2 theta is positive. Therefore, we know that 2 theta is in quadrant 3.